Hello, this is Kazan with Spellbinders Paper Arts. Today I'd like to share with you a few tips and tricks to use Spellbinders Shape Abilities Die Delights. These are really intricate die templates with fine detailed edges as well as beautiful embossed features. I'd like to start off using the Window 2 die template. Now the Grand Caliber machine has two sweet spots on either side of the machine. This is going to ensure a deeper cut and a more even cut. Now, the tip here for you is to place your die template on the outer edges of your base plate A. This is going to ensure that we hit those sweet spots when we run our sandwich through. That's tip number one. Now, tip number two is regular kitchen wax paper. This is going to ensure that we're able to remove the cut die from the template with those intricate edges without tearing them. Okay, so I'm going to tape my wax paper to my base plate A so that it doesn't move on me. Just going to tape it on either side, and then I'm going to position my cardstock right on top of the wax paper, like that. So I've got my template, my wax paper, and my cardstock. Cover that with my cutting plate C and run the sandwich through the Grand Caliber machine. Just like that. Alright, let's take a look. After removing the cut paper and the wax paper, I can see that I was able to hit those sweet spots beautifully. I've got an even cut edge all the way around. Now, if this is not the case, I would simply have turned my base plate around and run the sandwich through a second time to ensure that I get all the edges cut. Now, Spellbinders is known for its embossing features on its die templates. So let's go ahead and emboss this design too. I'm covering my template with my embossing mat and my embossing plate. I'm going to run my sandwich through the Grand Caliber machine to get those fine embossing details. Let's remove the plates and the mat. Oh my goodness, look at that. The wax paper has worked beautifully. I'm able to retrieve my project without even prying it from the template. Look at that beautiful embossed details. Now, I'm simply going to take my die cut, place it back in my die template, and I'm going to use the stencil feature of Spellbinders die templates. I'm able to stencil right through the die template to enhance that embossed detail and create an extra feature on my project. Remove the template and we can see the beautiful detailed stencil technique on my embossed edges. Alright, next up we have Medallion 4. We have two die templates that give us multiple designs. I'm going to start off by showing you that we can use these die templates in various ways. The first one has very detailed cut edges. And we're going to simply cut a window design from cardstock using this die template alone. It creates a unique design, or we could simply contrast it against white cardstock. Look at that, equally beautiful. If we take a closer look, we can see those very fine detailed cut edges. The second die template in the set is going to give us a more solid background. It can be used on its own or paired up with a more detailed medallion, and that's going to create a beautiful design too. Finally, I'm going to nest the two die templates in each other. This is going to give me a solid border around the cut design. Now, I have a tip for you here. The tip is to tape the two die templates, the two nested die templates, to the cardstock to ensure that they don't move, and thereby giving us an even border around the cut shape. So I'm going to simply nest them on the cardstock, and then I'm going to position the die template so that I have an even border all the way around and tape the die templates together to the cardstock. Once I've run it through the grain caliber machine, I'm able to get an even border all the way around, and it's going to give me this beautiful shape. Now I'd like to show you Fantastic Flourish 3. This is one of my favorite die templates. It has tons of detail and embossing features. It is beautiful on its own and can be used in cards, scrapbook pages, and home decor projects. However, this particular die template and others like it are equally impressive if we cut several of them at the same time and line them up to form a border, or even four at once to form a larger medallion. I'm just going to lay them out like that to show you. I love this look. This would be really impressive on a scrapbook page or as a home decor project. Finally, the Medallion 6 is another set that we have. Once again, this die template comes with three die templates in the set with multiple cutting and embossing and stenciling options. We can nest the solid background with the cut background to form this beautiful shape. But the fun feature on this die template is the shapes that we cut out. Don't discard them. They too form lovely shapes to use and further enhance your projects. This would be darling as a little leaf design, or even if we put several together, we can form a pretty little flower. I'm thinking even cut from white cardstock, a different, unique snowflake design. Well, I really hope you've enjoyed my tips and techniques for using Spellbinder's Die Delights. Thank you for stopping by. See you soon.